Hello everyone, this is Mark Flop to Shepherd once again, and welcome back to NeoLemmix Introduction Pack 2020 edition. So we have finished the first two ranks, and the last two levels, well, the second last level in the previous rank took me a lot longer than I thought it would, but we're just going to move forward and carry on with basic training. So this is basic training one. It's confusing having a one there, because now it's two ones. Tower training, 30 lemmings, 25 to be saved. Welcome to the basic training ranks. These ranks aim to teach you about the most common tricks and techniques used in levels. They should also provide you with more practice playing lemmings in general. First, a bit more of the routine part. Have fun solving the next two levels. So I'm forever having to adjust my volume for this game when I start playing this. Maybe start building a bit further back. I really shouldn't be umming on course, the side of caution here, because but after the level, after doing level 16 in the previous rank, I'm not pulling any punches now. I'm literally going to just try and make sure I'm not being too overconfident. I hate how the screen scrolls down when you do that. Again, it's just NeoLemmix doing that when you scroll down to go. It's annoying when you've got like space below you in a level and you've got to go down and pick a skill. I guess that's kind of what happens if you have a I forgot what I was going to say. If you're not going to use hotkeys to pick your skills like I don't, I just select them off the panel. Okay, well that wasn't too bad. Still took about 3 minutes to solve though. Not too bad there. Bit basher heavy, but which was why I was a bit cautious about bashing the signposts at the bottom of the level. Okay, basic training one, level two. With minimal efforts, 40 lemmings, 20 to be saved. Well, minimal is the name of this tile set, so that's the joke in a level title. Just a quick reminder, if you're ever unsure about what is terrain, what is steel, and what are objects in the level, do not hesitate to use clear physics mode. Well, let's take a bit of that advice. We can obviously see that the red objects in this level are the steel. I can see how it can be a bit confusing as well, because we have got red, like, drips on the ceiling here, but they're actually not classed as steel. Oh, nice, an 8 of everything level. And we've got unusual skill panel this time. Got no builders, more importantly. And we can't really just send one worker lemming, because we might need to use we might need to use stoners at one point. Actually, I don't think we need to use stoners, to be honest. No, we'll have to use a stoner for definite there. using a handy little trick here. I'm just taking advantage of the fact that there's a step down here, so I'm making sure the Lemmix can walk over this stacker this side and not walk back over the other side. It needs to be 6 pixels high. But I've noticed, unfortunately, when recording my videos, that the crosshair tends to be a lot bigger than the level sometimes, so maybe it's not displaying correctly in this case. Just to make sure no one's facing to the left. And no one did, that's good. Okay, they're a bit too bunched together for my liking. Okay, you end up turning around for some reason. But that's fine. Because you can just build the stacker. I'm just going to use stone for simplicity's sake, otherwise it's just going to be very messy on this bit. Although this lemming could probably get away with it. Okay, all the lemmings are out now. That wasn't a bad level there. Nice level that uses no builders. It's also nice to see a nice level done with a minimal tile set, because these levels always tend to be very difficult when I come across them in other people's level packs. Even one of my own level packs has got one of these levels in it, and it's like deemed as one of the hardest levels in the pack. But that's actually a level by Wafflem, so it's just me that designed the level, he designed the solution. Okay, so we're on to basic training 1, level 3. This time it's 100%er. Called Head Bumper. 20 lemmings, 20 to be saved. This level serves as a little reminder that builders and platformers turn around when they hit their heads on a ceiling, and they also turn around if they build right into something. In the platform's case, the lemming has to be right under the ceiling, 1 pixel to be exact. Okay, well, I worked that out last time because it wasn't actually stated in the levels in the level before where it was just talked about. On top of that, be sure to remember that if, for example, a basher or a miner hits steel, he turns around as well. Okie dokie, so we've got a little bit of a puzzle here. Well, only one thing we can do, really, send a climber to the left. Question is, we could use both a platformer or a builder here. And because of the way the trajectory is on the way that slope is, we can't actually turn around a builder there. Okay, so we can waste 2 constructive skills because we need one there. We need to save the platformer for this bit because the platformer turns around if we hit the other side there. So there's deductiveness at work for you. So it's just the builders that get burned. So now we wait for the lemming to walk up here, and he will walk up this bit because lemmings will traverse like up to 6 pixels above them through terrain, which is actually can be quite annoying in some cases, but can be quite useful in other cases. And he also spoke about miners turning around, so make sure that the miner hits the steel. That's probably a common mistake that even expert players might make. Because note, if the climber were to carry on and not turn around, he would climb and we'd have no skills to stop him walking off the side of the screen here. So remember, the side of the screen is deadly. We learnt that in the second rank. Because that's where the boogeyman hides. Okay, that wasn't too bad. So we've been going for about 10 minutes now and we've solved 3 levels. So I'll probably go on for another 5-6 minutes. Maybe we'll solve another 2 levels, who knows. Well, this one looks like a little blocker rocker. Okay, well, I am the king of blockers. Unofficial, of course. So we're on to basic training 1, level 4. 100 lemmings, 99 to be saved. Blockers are an effective way of containing the crowd so that a single worker lemming can create a safe way to the exit undisturbed. That is such news to me, the king of blockers. But how to release the crowd after the work is done? So that's what blockers are used for, because I use them for other things. Walkers can be used to turn blockers into a normal walker again, while bombers can blow them out of the way. Removing the terrain underneath the blocker also does the trick, and all kinds of destructive skills can be used for that purpose. Even diggers can work if lemmings land right on top of the blocker. This is not news to me, and I've got other things I can do to free blockers as well. And there's other magical things that blockers can do. Land right on top of the blocker, for example, when a blocker is placed right underneath the hatch. Now let's train this. You like that phrase? Let's train this. Okay, well, this one, these guys are on steel, so this is probably where the blocker and the walker is going to go. And this is probably set up for a basher. This is the one which is set up for the digger, so we have to do this one. So it's quite easy to see which blocker is going to be freed by what. Now, either of these can be used. Either of these lemmings above or below here could be the one that blows up. His question is, which one has been the good blocker and which one's been the bad blocker? Which one deserves to live? I'm not sure if that's even an option. Well, there doesn't seem to be a time limit on this level anyway, so... Okay, well, we're all done here. And luckily, it doesn't matter if these lemmings land to the left because there's a wall here. I don't know why there's a wall there, though. Okay, well, I'm going to do a little bit of eeny, miny, moe. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch something by the toe. Oh, I can't even do it. Oh, well. He stopped on this blocker, so we're going to blow this guy up. I don't know the rhyme. I'm embarrassed to admit it. So notice how when you bash underneath a blocker, it frees the blocker. Now with a miner, you have to do it right up next to the blocker, otherwise it's not going to work. Because what happens otherwise is the blocker ends up turning the miner around because he gets caught in the blocker field. So we need to mitigate the blocker before the blocker field can take effect. Okay, I messed up there. So I'm going to insert an action here using the replay overwriter. I shouldn't really be doing that, but I just wanted to get it done before the release rate was done. So all the other assignments will be done as normal. That was a good level. That was. That's a good blocker training level. Should hire Ecotoolot to make training levels for all of our packs, because I really struggle to make levels like this. In fact, I can't make levels like this. I just suck. Okay, so we've got time for one more level. Okay, Steely Walls, basic training 1, level 5. 20 lemmings, 10 to be saved. Okay, we've got no wall of text this time. Doesn't look too bad. I think this is more to like make sure you use the right skill, because obviously the platform is the correct choice here, and building then platforming, actually no, that's not particularly great either. And we can use a fencer here, because it's probably, fencers aren't really going to be very useful when we're trying to go down. Probably theoretical to save 100% on this level, but I'm not even going to try, to be honest. That was a nice quick one. So I'm going to stop the video here because we've done 5 levels. I'm going to try and keep the videos a bit shorter now, because the earlier ones were incredibly long in some cases. Again, not my fault with the one before this one. So thanks a lot for watching, and I shall see you in the next video.